to be here right now. Genuinely, from my heart, I cannot explain how amazing it is for me to come to a place that is so far away from my home, and to have a room this big watching me sing is amazing. So thank you so much for being here tonight. And this is an especially special night because I had to cancel my last show that I was going to do here. So tonight I'm going to sing harder than I ever have before. Are you ready to have a good time tonight? Are you ready to sing every single word tonight? Are you ready to sing every single word, even if you do not know the words? I'm so glad. I'm going to be singing some songs right now from my only album, my debut album, In the Lonely Hour. And this next one is one of my personal favourites. And this is called Leave Your Lover. I just want to say to you guys that I haven't done a full show in about a month and a half now. And coming back right now and performing on this stage just reminds me how much I love my job so much. So thank you for making it possible for us all to be here. Manila, say a big hello to my incredible band behind me tonight. We have been on the road now for nearly 3 years in total. And this album has been the most incredible thing that's ever happened to me in my life. And the most magical thing about what I do, number one is seeing you guys, but the second most magical thing about my job is getting an opportunity to meet you all face to face and talk to you and explain to you a little bit about this record, because this album was such a huge breakthrough in my life. Before I wrote this album, I was writing songs from a very, very young age, and a lot of the songs I wrote were terrible, absolutely awful. But there was a few songs that I was writing from a young age that were very honest, but I could never properly crack it. And this album signifies me basically being myself in my music, which is a huge thing for me. I hope you like it.
Never love you like you can.
so much, guys. Right, ladies and gentlemen, does anybody here tonight know a girl called Amy Winehouse? This is for you, Amy. All I can ever do is promise that we know. You having a good time? May I say a big hello to Ruben and Harry. I'd like to take this time to slow things down a little bit and sing two songs for you, which I feel really truly are the heart and the soul of this album. I set out to write this record because when I started writing this album 3 years ago, I fell in love with someone who didn't love me back. And I was incredibly lonely and incredibly sad. And the only way for me to get through that was to express it through my music. And now here I stand, 2015, and I am over this person, which is a good thing. I no longer feel lonely, and I feel happier than I ever have, which is amazing. And sometimes now when I'm singing these songs, it's hard for me to feel these songs in the core like I used to. So these songs that I'm about to sing for you are no longer my songs, they are your songs. And I truly hope that they can help you through any lonely moments or hours you may have in your life. Because they helped me so much. So I hope you like this, Manila. And I say I love you. And it's hard for me and I hate. days just seem so dark. The moon and the stars and nothing without you. Your thoughts, your skin, where do I begin? No words can explain the way I'm missing you. The night, this emptiness, this hole that I'm inside. These tears, they tell their own story. Told me not to cry when you were gone. But the feeling's overwhelming. It's much too strong. Can I lay by your side next to you? Sing a song. Will you help me sing this next one? Who knows this song? That's good. But Manila, I know you can be a little bit louder than that. Very good. Very, very good. But one more time for me, guys. As loud as you possibly can. Manila, who does this song? Manila, I'm gonna sing for you guys is actually the only song on my album which isn't about love. I wrote this song a couple of years ago and about someone who I do not like very much. I wrote this song about an artist, a musician, well, he attempts to be a musician, and the song is basically about how when I get in the studio and when I write music so that I can stand on stages like this and sing to you guys every night. And the person who this song was about, their only incentive to write music was for money. So, to cut a long story short, I was so annoyed and so upset, I wrote this next song about this person, so I hope you enjoy.
I'll do it.
Let me see everybody's lights in the air. Everybody put your phones in the air. Now sway with me. You guys look so amazing right now. To the end of my record. And although this album was a sad album to write, I decided that I didn't want to end this record on a sad note, because I am actually quite a happy person most of the time. Most of the time. So I decided to write a song to end this album with Jimmy Napes and Howard from Disclosure, and I said to the guys that I want this song to be a letter to my first boyfriend, whoever that may be. This is called Make It To Me.
Distant stranger, then I will complete.
tonight has been so amazing. And I really hope that we made up for cancelling earlier on at the end. Here we go! Is it true? I'm not good at what I said. Remember still being hard. This has never seemed to go. But I don't want to believe you are my friend.
Should be late and please don't be sad. And I want you.